The Bukedea District Woman Member of Parliament, Anita Annette Among, has today been declared the Speaker of the 11th Parliament to replace the fallen former Speaker, Jacob Ulanya, who passed away on Sunday in the United States. Among, who was nominated by the Prime Minister Robina Nabbanja, defeated the opposition's joint candidate Asuman Basalirwa, nominated by the leader of opposition Mathias Mpuuga, in a landslide victory of 401 votes against 66.
96, 97, 98. 99.
Only one vote was invalid out of the 468 votes cast at Kololo Independence Grounds.
I hereby declare Among Anita Annette as the duly elected Speaker of the 11th Parliament.
President Yoweri Museveni administered the oath to the Speaker Among and handed her instruments of power, including the mess, coat of arms, and the national flag to succeed Ulanya. Basalirwa conceded defeat and appreciated MPs for their support.
Honorable members of parliament, first of all, permit me to take this opportunity to thank all of you for participating in this process. I am greatly indebted to every single member of parliament here who has taken time to be part of this democratic process. We want to salute you and to thank you for the spirit and gesture. Permit me in a special way to appreciate the 66 members of parliament that have bestowed upon me a title which is not expressly provided in the rules, but which I am glad to call myself the title of Shadow Speaker. I want to thank you so much, the 66.
In her victory speech, Among took time to pay tribute to her predecessor and appreciated the president for doing everything possible to save Ulanya's life, which wasn't possible.
Let me take the opportunity also to thank God for the life of our late Honorable Jacob Lokori Ulanya. We talk about Jacob today because we would not be here undertaking this exercise had he been amidst us. That's why we are referring to Jacob in each and every speech. Your Excellency, I take the opportunity to thank you as a country under your stewardship in everything humanly that you did in ensuring that you saved the life of Honorable Jacob Ulanya. But then God's timing is never our timing. But all the same, we want to thank you as Parliament and as people of Uganda. Today is a day of a mixed emotions, a day when we continue to mourn our fallen leader, a friend, a father, a twin brother to me, as he had always referred to, and yet the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda, which we saw and uphold too, dictates that the constitutional process must be undertaken. Your Excellency and Honorable Members, this is a day I never imagined would happen this soon, especially because I believed for the next 5 years or 10 years, I would still be the Deputy Speaker and Jacob would be the Speaker. I would have had a strong mentor and a stronger leader in Jacob, but we thank God for everything.
Among promised factual debates with focus on common Ugandans to drive the socio-economical transformation of the country, she promised to be a speaker for everyone and urged MPs to observe decorum and mutual respect to each other.
The leadership of 11th Parliament will continue to be guided by the vision to have people-centered parliament that is anchored on evidence-based debate. Honorable colleagues shall base all their decision on facts, reasons, sound logic presented to the House.
Anita Among, who was in FDC before joining the NRM party, is an accountant and a lawyer. She has been serving as the deputy speaker and now becomes the second female speaker of Parliament of Uganda after Rebecca Kadaga, who superintended over Parliament for 10 years.